Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to go over a few different ways to share your screen within Microsoft Teams. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. Here's a Teams meeting that I already joined a little while ago. And up here is the button to share your screen with other people who are in your meeting. So let's go over some of these options right now. If I click on share, I can see that I can share my screen or I can share my window. And do you see this little six up here? That means that I have six different windows open. So when I go into share and I pick screen, I will be sharing my entire desktop. So just think of this one as someone is sitting right next to you in a meeting and they can see everything you are doing on your computer. So if you are switching between windows, they will be able to see each one of those windows. But if I go over here to share just a window, they will only see the window that I select here. So let's see how both of those work. I'm going to click screen for the first example. So the first thing I want you to notice is this big red box around the edges of my screen. When I see that big red box, that means that window is being shared with everyone who is on my Teams meeting. So if I Alt-Tab over to Excel, you can see that that red border still exists. And then if I Alt-Tab to my Microsoft Word document, you can see there's also a red border around my Microsoft Word document. So the red border is really up there to let you know that everyone can see what you're doing on the screen at the moment the red border is there. To stop sharing your screen, you may have this box down here, and you can click the screen sharing button, but it now has an X on it. So click that, and you will see that the red border has completely gone away. But let's see what my other options for sharing are. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. If I click on share again, this time I'm going to pick window and I'm being asked which of my windows do I want to share. So let's say I would just like to share my Excel window. Look around my Excel window. You can see that there is a red border, but if I Alt tab back to Word, you can see that red border goes away. So what that means is the people in my Teams meeting cannot see this screen that I have brought up. But if I Alt-Tab back to Excel, you can see that the red border has come back. So that is my visual, that is the screen that is being shared. So if my shared window is open and I accidentally close the shared window, I will be taken right back to Teams and the share button will now have the up arrow and I will not be sharing anymore. So the fact that Microsoft Teams comes back on your screen should be a cue to you that you have closed the one window that you are sharing. But let's go back to sharing that Excel window for a minute. You can see my red border again, but one thing I want to let you know that's really important here is sometimes when you go up to certain pop-up boxes inside of Excel, whoever is watching the meeting may or may not be able to see those. One example of this is if I right-click on a cell and I go to Format Cells, the other people in your Teams meeting may be able to see this Format Cells box right here. And if I cancel out of there and go up to Conditional Formatting, the people inside of your Teams meeting will not be able to see the Conditional Formatting box. So it's not really consistent here. So if you are choosing to do a demo that is more than just going over the spreadsheet. So if you are doing like a training tutorial or something where people will have to see those other options in order to understand where they are, you might want to share your desktop and only keep the Excel window up so that the people who are in your meeting can see those pop-up dialog boxes. So in other words, some of those pop-up dialog boxes are part of the screen sharing within Excel, and some of them are seen as a different window altogether, so they will not be seen when you are sharing your screen if you are using the share window mode. So if I X out of here and I'm taken back to Teams, let me just show you that again. If I hit the share window, in here, if I've chosen this option, some of those pop-up windows may not be seen. But if I choose to share my screen, all of those pop-up windows will definitely be seen by other people in your meeting. So just remember, if I hit share and then I hit screen and I'm in Microsoft Word and then I hit Alt Tab thinking no one else is on here and I go to write a new email to someone in the meeting, isn't this meeting boring? Notice the red box that's around my message. Everyone is going to see you writing that message. So you probably want to make sure you're not in screen sharing mode if you don't want everyone to be able to see what you're doing. I'd like to give you a few additional tips for sharing your screen. So if I'm in share screen mode and I'm in Microsoft Word, sometimes when other people in your meeting are watching, this screen is very, very small on their end. So it's a good idea for the windows that you're sharing that you restore them instead of minimizing or maximizing. So just hit this restore down button. And if you share the screen in this mode, it's a little easier for your users to be able to see what you are doing. The text will be a little bit bigger on their end. Also, if I minimize this and I right click on my desktop and I go to display settings and I go down here to change the size of text and apps and other items, usually it's at 125 or 150%. But if I adjust this to be larger, maybe say 175%, users on the other end will see my screen with bigger text and it will be easier for them to follow along. And one more tip. If I'm going to share a window, before I hit the share button, it's a good idea to already have those windows open because when I hit share and I hit windows, I'm going to get a list right here of only my open windows. So if that window is not open yet, it's not going to appear here. Notice in this list, my Excel document is gone. So before I enable the share, I will need to go to Excel, open that file, and then when I go back to Teams, if I hit share and I hit Windows, that file will now appear in that list. So hopefully this gives you a quick introduction to some of your options when you share your screen inside of Microsoft Teams. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below and we will definitely get back to you. Hopefully you learned something new today and look forward to seeing you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.